Hello, my name is Lance Foster, and I work as Tribal Historic Preservation Officer here on the Iowa Reservation of Kansas and Nebraska. And there's a language study group that we have once a week. Usually, it's been in the warm months, in the evening on Wednesdays, but during the cold months, we change it to Sundays in the afternoon. A lot of people live elsewhere. A lot of our tribal members live elsewhere and have expressed interest in being part of this group, but because of the distance, haven't been able to. So this will be the first episode of this effort to kind of get people up to speed on the basics of the language. And hopefully, like I said, we kind of learn together. It is probably the first thing has to happen is introduce you to at least the basic language material that we're going to use. There are a lot of people over the years who have developed language materials. Some of the early things were developed by Gordon Marsh in the 1930s. Dorsey developed things in the 1890s. The missionaries, Hamilton and Irvin, developed a lot of materials in the 1850s. 1840s, 1850s. So that material is a little hard to come by sometimes, and some of the people are more familiar with some of the more recent work. Probably the most well-known piece of work is was done 1977, 1978 by Lila WIstrand Robinson. Two primers. There's a blue cover and a tan cover, book one and book two. And she has tapes that go with it. Jim Goodtracks, who worked with her on the project, also has CDs and copies of it available through his website, which you can Google and find copies of this book. What we're going to do, because this is the most probably available book for people, even though there are some differences that different people have, like the difference between using the R recently in some of the work versus the L that was used back in the 70s for the same sound. But at the very least, at least we can get you started. Some people are well along, well past this, and this is not for them unless they want to review. But these are the studies for people who want to start out. So, because of the uploading situation, I want to try to keep it to short episodes, no more than 4 or 5 minutes long. And we're 3 minutes now. So let me just show you what we're going to use for this Jiwede, Jiwede Bakhoje, Washige Ukenye Iche. That means Oto Iowa person, Washige Ukenye. Ordinary, that means Indian, Washige, Kenya, each a language. So we'll use that. Again, like I said, it was written in 1977. These were the consultants for the Christian Children's Fund that she notes as having participated, for those who want to know what the sources were. Fanny Grant, Grace Kahiga, Alice Sein, Joel Young, Truman Daly, Robert Moore, Franklin Murray, and you see that's copyright 77. So this is, she was a linguist, I believe, Lila Wilson Robinson, and the artwork, here's also this early work was Gordon Marsh. Jim helped make sure that this was published, and Ota Indian Children of Red Rock School were the ones who did the artwork for it. So this is not high tech. This is not a big production. But here you have the table of contents, which will start out with sounds, the vowels. We'll start with that. Then the consonants, the nasalized vowels, consonant combinations, the Big Turtle Song, Hunting Story. They'll go into conversations. So, why don't we just go ahead and take a quick look at the alphabet This is page, well, it's been stamped 11, but I think in the original it's a different page number. So this kind of looks at some of the sounds, but we'll go break down one by one. Talks about the letters F, Q, R, V, and Z are not found in our alphabet. And let's see. See if I can try to read this at the same time as showing it to you. So the letters F, Q, R, V, and Z are not found in the Ioway-Otoe-Missouria alphabet since those sounds are not in our Indian language. The letter C is used only in combination with H as CH, otherwise only K is used for the sound, beginning English words as king and cat, omitting the inconsistency of English spelling, although we now have our own inconsistent spelling at times as well. The apostrophe following Y is a glottal stop, uh-oh, as found in uh-oh of English. Vowels A, E, I, O, U have the basic ah, A, E, O, U sounds, as in Spanish, with a few exceptions due to nasalization or lack of stress. Consonants P, T, K, and CH are aspirated. B, D, G, and J are either unaspirated or voiced. Consonant L is not English L. Now, this is a big sticking point for people, but rather flapped with a quick tap, similar to the Spanish flapped R, as in pero. Consonant X is in German, K and Achtung, a guttural sound made with friction over the back of the tongue. There are combinations with N, Inya, as in English canyon, NG, as in English singing. Combinations with H are CH, as in English church, THE, as in English they, SH, in English shoe, th, as an English thing. And then there are combinations with apostrophes such as ch, p, t, k, s, and kh. These sounds are not found in English. There's construction of the glottis when the consonant is articulated, producing what sounds like a slight pause between the consonant and the vowel, as heard by laymen. Now this stuff, kind of dense to get through on this kind of a video, but it's just an intro. We will go through these, all of this stuff slowly and give examples. So be patient. I am going to go ahead and close this up. This is almost eight minutes now. But next time we'll start with ah, the ah sound. See you on the next one.